Hi children, today we are going to continue our class with chapter 3, exercise 2 with division topic. So in exercise 1 we saw how to do multiplication with 3 digit numbers. So here we are going to see again how to do division with 2 digit numbers. So in 4th standard itself, in detailedly you would have seen, you would have learnt and did many sums, how to do division with 1 digit, 2 digit, and how to do with remainder, without remainder and all. We'll just see a glance again to recall the division concept. So here I have written a sum to do division with 2 digit number. So always the number which is given to you towards your left side, you will call it as dividend. And the number after which is given to division symbol, you will call it as towards right side, you will call it as divisor. Yes, so we'll just move on. Always this divisor will be written outside the division symbol. That is, here inside the dividend has to be written 82006. Okay, so whenever you do division, first of all you should consider the divisor. You should check what is the number of digit which is given to you in the divisor. So in divisor you have 2 digit. So always you are supposed to take 2 digit from the inside of the division column, which is in the dividend. From the dividend you should consider 2 numbers. Okay, 2 digit of numbers, because the divisor is 2 digit. So the first number you are going to take it as a 2 digit. So here it is 80, so that you will be doing division with 80 table. That is you can also just have a shortcut like, if you just hide the 0 is 8, you will have 8. You can consider the 8 table and you can just add one 0 with the value. You will be feeling very easy to find the value. So here 80, 82. So in 80 table, 80 ones are is 80. So after writing 80 into 1 gives 80. That is 80 ones are. That time is there, no? 80 into 1. That 1 has to be written in the quotient. And the answer, 80 into 1 is equal to 80. No, that is equal to, after answer you will write the down below the 82. So with these 2 values you will do subtraction. Okay. So after subtraction, 2 minus 0 gives 2. 8 minus 8 gives 0. So after subtraction you got the value 2. So now you have some more digits in the dividend. So you should bring one by one only as a down. So first I am bringing this 0 down. So now this 2 has become 20. So now you should check whether 20 will come in 80 table. This 20 is smaller than the 80. So we can't able to do division. That is, in 80 table 20 will not come, because 80 ones are is 80. So 20 will not come in 80 table. In that case, when you can't able to do division with the dividend value, once you brought down the digit down, you are supposed to do division. If you can't able to do division, in that case you should give 10 in the quotient. Okay, so since I can't do able to do division with this 20, I am giving the 0 in the quotient. So after giving the 0 here in the quotient only, I should bring a next number down. Okay, as it is I cannot bring the second digit down. Since it is also a dividend, you cannot bring 2 numbers at a time without reason. Okay, so now I brought down another 0 here. Now it has become 200 instead of 20. Okay, so now I should check how many times I will get 200 in 80 table, or less than 200. So I should write always the lesser value to minus here. I should not write the greater value to do the subtraction. So you know the subtraction concept, no? Always we will do subtraction only with the greatest number. So keep in mind that, and you will write the lesser value always when you bring the answer here. So now in 80 table, 80 ones are answer is 80. 82s are is 160. Okay. So I'm going to do 82s are is 160. So now subtract this 200 and 160. 0 minus 0 is 0. And 0 minus 6, I should borrow from 1. That is from 2 I borrowed 1. 10 minus 6 gives 4. And 1 minus 1 gives 0. So now the value have become 40 after subtracting from 200 to 160. So now I have one more digit in the dividend. So I am bringing that one digit down as 6. Okay, now the value have become 406. Okay, so now I should check how many times I will get 406 in 80 table or below 400. The value should be below 406. So I am just checking in 8 table. Okay, so 80 in 8 table I will get 5 8s are or 8 5s are is 40. Okay, so that 80 into 5 gives 400. 80 into 5. 80 5s are gives 400. So now I am going to do subtraction with 406 with 400 and you will get 6 as a reminder. So this is called as quotient and this you will call it as reminder. So after doing the division, you can check your division answer by checking it. So how to check that? That is to check your division value, you can do multiplication by quotient into divisor plus remainder, you will get dividend. So this is a formula to check your answer. That is, quotient is your upside value, divisor is your towards your left side value, no, outside the symbol, that is your divisor. And if you multiply these two values and with that answer if you add the remainder, you will get the dividend value. Okay, we'll just see, check and see whether the answer is right or wrong. So the quotient is 1025 into divisor. Divisor is 80. So first I am going to do multiplication, quotient and divisor. So 10 I am placing it and I am going to multiply with 8. 8 5s are is 40. 4 remainder. 8 2s are 16. And 16 plus 4 gives 20. So 2 as a reminder. 8 into 0 gives 0. And 0 plus 2 gives 2. And now 8 into 1 gives 8. So now I got 82,000 after multiplying quotient and divisor. Now I should add the remainder. With here is 6. If you add 0 plus 6, you will get 6. So now you got the value of dividend, 82,006. The dividend value is also 82,006. So your division is right. Okay. So hope you have understood how to do division and you can check your answer by multiplying the quotient with your divisor and by adding your remainder so that you will get your dividend value. Okay. Thank you.